Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My own training in Sharia. How did I study Sharia and reach where I am? Personal experience. Well, quite unusual. It is through personal effort, personal interest, but family background and the country where I was born and brought up. I was born in a family of my father, grandfather, closely associated with Islam and Sharia. They were judges, senior judges. And if you are brought up in that kind of environment, there is a basic kind of beginning. But my father was a scholar of Sharia. He paid considerable attention to our education, especially in Islamic disciplines. Early in the morning, I recall, he would wake up us after Salat. And this was when we started school at an early stage. About 5 or 6 years of age, he would wake up us and then start reading Arabic, Quran and Tafsir and later Hadith. And before school time, we would have had about 1 hour, 1.5 hours of this almost regularly as personal attention. And then when you go to school, I went to primary school and then secondary school and also my first degree in law and political science. They were all in Afghanistan. And when you go through all this, even if you don't go to the madrasa background, and the school itself, Afghanistan is sort of the school curricula was quite, deeply entrenched in Islamic disciplines. And for example, we at the level of the primary school, we had a subject, theology. As the middle school and secondary, then we had a subject, both theology and Arabic. And then right up, even after school at the university, at the law faculty, fiqh was a basic subject all these years. So that gives you a certain degree of exposure and grounding in both Arabic and also Sharia, if you go to the law stream. Then it was through my personal interest because of my background. In a certain degree of, if you know more about something through practice and learning, you begin to develop your thoughts and interests. And then it became a kind of, from one stage to another, Then came the time when I started teaching. This teaching was probably a more intensive experience of finding, the kind of depth and scope that I have developed. It was through basically teaching. When I started teaching at McGill University, it was at master's and PhD level. And when you are asked to teach, it's a different experience to being a student. You have to master your subject before you can deliver it. And those at a higher level. I went through a lot of difficult times, doing that. But I taught Islamic jurisprudence at McGill University. And then at the International Islamic University, various other subjects like Islamic family law, Islamic principles of government in Islam, legal theory, different subjects. So you become a kind of, you diversify. And each time you do that, you develop your knowledge of the Sharia. It's like studying as well as teaching, but teaching you know, places you in a high level of under demand at that level. But then my own writing, and this has become another level of, you know, deepening your knowledge of the Sharia. And each book that I wrote, it was a training in that branch of the Sharia. In my own selection, for example, of the books that I did, I decided that it will have to be mainstream, like textbooks. And because I was teaching, I came to International Islamic University, Malaysia, to teach Islamic jurisprudence, but there was no text on Usul al-Fiqh, not a good text that you could really offer to your students. Islamic University is, you know, specialization and the kind of number of subjects that you teach at that level. So I addressed myself to that task, that I will write a textbook on Islamic jurisprudence. Basically, the principles of Islamic jurisprudence I wrote was for that purpose, to teach it. It became a world-class textbook now at Harvard, Cambridge. Is that book, but I only revised and updated it later. But alhamdulillah, that was a success. Once you have written a textbook of that kind, you establish yourself as a kind of, you know, not just a learner, but someone like a specialist in the subject. It's interesting, when I published that book in 1989, I was teaching at the Law Faculty, Kulliyah of Law, at the old campus. People in my faculty, you know, Tan Sri Ahmad Ibrahim was around, and Ustaz Ghazali Nawawi was dean. They started asking questions, how come he wrote a textbook on Islamic jurisprudence? He's not from Azhar. He did this and that. And this was, it took a time. It took time. There was an Egyptian scholar who came as a visiting temporary scholar. He came for a week or two. And I learned the first thing, he was asked to look at my book to see whether it is credible. And instead of he reporting to them, he called me at home. He said, this is the best book I've seen. And that book really was a very good effort. And then I, you know, continued on this, choosing mainstream. Like I wrote a book on, a textbook on Hadith studies. Freedom of expression in Islam. This was a little more specialized. But freedom, equality, and justice in Islam, mainstream. I had a basic sense of mission. As I was trained both in Islamic countries and in the West, I did my master's degree and PhD at London University. And you become aware, I think this is your other question. You become aware of the differences in the needs. I thought that there was a need to communicate in English language, in the language that people in the West, in the students in the West can understand in their language. Make the Sharia better understood. And I think that I must have perhaps been motivated to that, having experienced that the knowledge of Sharia was from a certain perspective, then it did not really convey the kind of background I was familiar with. So that was the kind of, I thought this was done best, to do mainstream textbooks and all that.